Dominance is a phenomenon in which one allele masks the effect of the other. That's how we understand it. But we've also learned that in some cases, a dominant allele does not completely suppress the recessive one. The blend of both the genes is seen with an intermediate phenotype. And what if both the different genes are dominant? In such exceptional cases, an individual with both the phenotypes is obtained. We have learned all the three types of dominance so far. Let's do a quick review for all the three types. Firstly, can you tell me what dominance is? Technically, it can be defined as the relation between two alleles of a gene and the associated phenotype. That means dominance is all about how one dominant allele of a particular gene interacts with the other recessive or dominant allele of the same gene set in an organism. So if T is one allele from a gene set which is dominant for the trait height, then its effect on the other allele, which may be T or T, is called dominance. Based on the gene interactions, dominance is categorized into three types: complete dominance, which is very common in nature, and incomplete and codominance, which are relatively rare. Let's review all these three types with one common and simple example. We can hypothetically take the alleles capital B and lowercase w to represent different flower colors. Let B be the allele for flower color blue, which we consider as dominant, and the allele for white flowers, which will be a recessive trait, will be represented by the letter W in lowercase. So the genotype of the plant with blue flowers will be BB in capital, and that of white flowered plants will be WW in lowercase, considering both are homozygous. The first type in the list is complete dominance. Here, the dominant allele will mask the effect of the recessive allele completely. So on crossing the blue and the white flowered plants, we will obtain only blue-colored flowers. To be precise, on crossing the two homozygous varieties, we will get all heterozygous offsprings. Now, this being a case of complete dominance, all the plants will have blue-colored flowers. Can you state an example of complete dominance found in nature? Most of the dominant traits fall under this category. For example, the purple color of flowers, axial flower position, tall height of the plant, all these characters found in a pea plant fall under the category of complete dominance. Next in the list is incomplete dominance. In this type, the dominant allele masks the effect of the recessive one, but not completely. That means a phenotype which is intermediate of the two parents is obtained in the F1 hybrid. Any guesses what will happen in this case? If this is a case of incomplete dominance, then an intermediate of the two colors will be obtained. Maybe light blue color? Theoretically, BB crossed with WW will give us BW. So genotypically, all the F1 hybrids will have both the alleles. Phenotypically, all of the offsprings will have an intermediate color between dark blue and white. In nature, incomplete dominance is seen in plants like the 4 o'clock plants. In humans, we've seen that the incomplete dominance is seen in hair type. Curly hair, which is a dominant trait, when crossed with straight hair, that is a recessive trait, gives us wavy hair. Wavy hair is a trait intermediate of both the types, and hence it's an example of incomplete dominance. Now comes the third type, which is called codominance. Let's assume we have another dominant allele for the red-colored flower. So the genotype of a plant with this colored flower will be RR. Any idea what will happen if this plant is crossed with the one having blue-colored flowers? Both red and blue-colored flowers are dominant traits. So both the alleles will try getting expressed with equal strength. As a result, we will obtain a progeny that has either blue flowers with red patches or red flowers with blue patches. That means both blue and red colors will be seen in the flowers. Theoretically, the cross of RR and BB will yield F1 hybrids with the genotype RB. As a result, flowers having petals with both colors will be obtained. Codominance is found widely in nature. Most common examples of codominance that we've learnt include the human blood groups, coat color in cattle and in many other animals. Mendelism revolves around complete dominance as it doesn't favor blending of characters. Hence, the other two types, incomplete and codominance, are commonly studied as exceptions to Mendelism.